This tutorial provides an overview of the Hilti PROFIS Ferroscan Map software and explains its main applications. This software is designed to arrange multiple image scans or quick scans recorded via the Hilti Ferroscan on a virtual wall. The resulting map shows the rebar layout and depth of concrete cover. Different colors can be assigned to indicate and visualize individual depth layers. The area visualization and provided statistics give you a solid foundation to form your decisions. Now we'll go through how to optimize the handling of large amounts of scan data. First, the scan files need to be analyzed in PROFIS Detection before you import them to the PROFIS Ferroscan Map software. This step enables the processing of scan files from a complete project. In the PROFIS Detection software, the Ferroscan batch processing function automates the analysis of large amounts of data. After the batch processing is complete, you can open the Hilti PROFIS Ferroscan Map application. Within the application, you can change the basic settings for language, length unit, metric or imperial, preferred color map, and the archive folder. The color map allows you to assign color codes to different depth ranges for better visualization of areas with inadequate concrete cover. The toolbar includes options for opening an existing Ferroscan map project or creating a new map for quick scans or image scans. Let's create a new map to show how these features work in practice. Create a new map file by clicking the Quick Scan Area button. Enter the project information in the virtual wall properties, including dimensions and the distance between the scan lines. Select a project folder from your archives and import the analyzed scan files for mapping. To arrange the scan files in the correct sequence or order, select Advanced Direction and Scan Direction using the arrow symbols. The start position where the first scan will be inserted is shown. The upper left corner is the default point of origin for the map visualization. Each subsequent start position is advanced to the amount in the Advanced Direction increment field. The scan direction is the starting position of the quick scan recorded via the Ferroscan. Depending on the sequence scanned, choose to add selected scans individually or add all scans. Once you've placed the scan files, the multiple quick scans will appear arranged on a virtual wall for depth of cover analysis. In large area visualization, use the zoom function to see more detail. Remember, you can adjust the map's color code according to your needs and preferences. A good first step for evaluating the area is looking at the statistics overview. This may give you ideas for setting the color map and further processing of the viewing settings. These statistics results are dependent on the amount of data selected. For example, all data or a certain zoom section, and whether data points are cut off from top or bottom. The software lets you slice a certain thickness layer through the virtual wall, allowing for visualization of different concrete cover depths using the slider. Select Range Only to see the cover section of interest. The More Detailed Statistical Results tab provides thorough information to make judgments about depth of concrete cover. The top graph shows the distribution curve of the depth of concrete cover results for each measuring point in the units selected. Below the curve are three sliders. Top R. This slider removes the topmost measuring points that don't belong to the layer you want to analyze or takes away space holders and other data points that you don't want to include in the analysis. C-min. This slider sets the value C-min, which is the specified minimum depth of concrete cover, It also indicates how many measuring points are below that threshold depth value. Cutoff. This slider adjusts the cutoff level, allowing you to ignore bars that lay deeper than this level. All measuring points that remain in the section will provide the result information in statistic terms, mean and average concrete cover, min and max values, and the standard deviation value. Often the 0.5% quantile values are required for the assessment. The numbers remain in black font if the data is within the specified limits. If not, they turn red. The software generates a complete statistics report, including graphs. You can print the assessment report of the large area evaluation map and the calculated statistics data for documentation or archival purposes. For a new project, click the Image Scan Area button and enter the project information and virtual wall properties by number of scans in both directions. To import analyzed scan files for mapping, select a project folder from your archive. Select the starting point. By default, it's 1:1, meaning that the point of origin is in the upper left grid of the virtual map. Under Advanced Insert, you can select if to fill either the rows or the columns first, depending on how the scan data was captured. As in Quick Scan Map, select individual scans to be added or select Add All Scans, depending on the sequence scanned. The multiple image scans from the selected project will appear on the virtual wall. A first step for evaluating the area is to select the preferred data set under View Layers. Select either Originals, which means the raw signals, or the calculated results. Uncheck the Non-Verified checkbox in order to deactivate the data that are not reliable for the analysis. You can set the image scan to have only horizontal, only vertical, or both directions displayed. Then, look at the statistical data, which may give you hints for further processing and setting the color map. Areas may be evaluated with advanced statistical methods to make a better judgment about concrete coverage. The top graphic shows the distribution of bar coverages in millimeters from the actual scan. The same set of functionalities as in Quick Scan Map applies here, such as color mapping and depth ranges. Under the statistics, similar to the Quick Scan Map, the graph and the statistics data are provided. Statistics for both rebar layers, the vertical and the horizontal, are calculated. At the click of a button, you can get the complete statistics report, including graphs. If it's of interest to check the concrete cover for only one rebar layer, you can select either the horizontal or the vertical. Then the statistics will adapt respectively and generate a complete statistics report. You can print the map and the calculated statistics data for documentation purposes. When you're finished, you can export the results to various formats so that the data from PROFIS Ferroscan Map can be further imported into 3D CAD, computer-aided design software applications such as AutoCAD. You can also save the results for further use and archival purposes.